गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ना इन द प्रीवियस थ्री क्लासेस वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द डेफिनेशंस ऑफ सिंगल लाइन डायग्राम एंड इंपेडेंस डायग्राम एंड पर यूनिट इंपेडेंस डायग्राम आर द रिएक्टेंस डायग्राम सो एज आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू दैट दीज थ्री आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थियरी क्वेश्चंस समटाइम्स डायरेक्टली यू मे गेट दीज क्वेश्चंस फॉर 7 मार्क्स एक्सप्लेन द फॉलोइंग टर्म्स आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड दिस पॉइंट सेवरल टाइम्स okay please do remember now already in the last class we have discussed how to draw per unit impedance diagram and we have solved two problems based on the transformer and we have proved that the per unit impedance of the element which is connected either side of the transformer is same now we are going to see a very important problem in this particular class so on the completion of this problem shall wind up the session for today okay right now please all of you maintain a separate notebook for note down the problems I'm going to share my screen here now please note down this problem Please note on this. Please note down this problem carefully. Okay. So obtain the per unit impedance diagram, or you can also call the per unit impedance diagram as a reactance diagram okay for the given system and you have been given a single line diagram of a overall three phase balanced power system and for this particular system you are asked to draw or you are asked to sketch the per unit impedance diagram or the reactance diagram now as we have already discussed about the per unit quantities representation usage why we need to study about the per units of power system why we need to express all the specifications with the common base value why because suppose if now is it okay is the screen is visible to everyone Is it okay? Now, please, all of you, look at this. Okay, just wait a moment. Now, again, I am going to share my screen here. Now is it okay? Is my screen is visible? Yes. Okay. Thank you. Now see, obtain the per unit impedance diagram. Okay. I got your response. Okay. Thank you. Now, if you carefully observe this single line diagram, this. Entire single line diagram consists of so many components like generators circuit breakers transformers and transmission line system for each and every component you are having different specifications, right? So if this is happens, obviously it is not possible to analyze this type of systems. So that's why we need to bring all the specifications to a common platform, or by considering a base value, and later we are going to have the per unit value. So per unit value is equal to the actual value by base value. Already we have discussed about the expressions in the previous classes, right? Now this is the problem we are going to start with, right? Obtain the per unit impedance or the reactance diagram of the given system. Now you see here, so this is section one. Please carefully note down or draw the single line diagram with all specifications. I will give you some time, right? 30 MVA, 10.5 kV, and I already explained regarding the subtransient reactance of the particular alternator, whatever it may be. So whenever this type of representation is there, obviously you can consider that as a subtransient reactance. So of the alternator and the transformer, one section has been given. And now see here, this is 20.5 ohms per phase. This is a transmission line actual impedance value, right? Those are transformer two. Later, the last session contains remaining two alternators with 15 MVA and 25 MVA, and the static loads are also present, right? See, sometimes maybe because of your neck problem also, you are getting this type of technical problems. Okay, so you please maintain it. Okay, now is it okay? Is my voice is audible? Is my voice is audible? Right. See, because to avoid some disturbances, I have taken the full control over this session. So that's why I have muted all the participants. If you have any complaints regarding the screen visibility and the voice audibility, you just please put the same in the chat box so that I can able to understand what are your problems are. Right, thank you. Now see the problem is looks like a very large or too complicated, but the solution is very, very easy. But the only thing is you need to understand the concept and you need to remember the expressions what we have derived in the last classes. So that's why while doing the derivations or while doing the expressions, I told several times that this is very important. You need to remember this point throughout the completion of the subject. Every time I told these points, right? Okay. Now see here, line capacitances and resistances are neglected. See, these assumptions are already given in the problem itself. I have not considered these assumptions separately. These assumptions have been given directly in the problem itself. He has given a single line diagram, and for this you are asked to draw the per unit impedance diagram by considering these assumptions. So the first assumption is the line capacitance. See, I can't do anything. So many people are saying that voice is too low. So already now is it okay? Roll number 274. Is my voice is audible? Is it okay? 274. Right. See, please try to understand the problem also. See, I'm in my cabin, so. Right. Line capacitances and resistances are neglected. Assume that impedance diagram is meant for short circuit studies. Current drawn under these cases can be neglected. So load A, R, B are neglected. So directly you have been given that load A, and you need not consider that load A and load B, even though the load A and load B are present in the single line diagram, but you don't consider those two loads. Why? Because in the problem itself he has mentioned that you have to avoid the load A and the load B. So except load A and load B, you need to draw the per unit impedance diagram or the reactance diagram of this particular system, right? Write down. So the first and foremost important point here is we need to select proper base values. We need to select proper base values. Just wait a moment. See, that's why I told you several times that please don't make any disturbances. Class is already started at 9 o'clock. Still you are trying to join the session. Right. So assume the impedance diagram. So you need not consider the load A and the load B. And one more important point. So before going to draw a per unit impedance diagram of any system, first of all, the first and foremost important factor is you need to consider proper base values. Base values means KVA base or MVA base and KV base. MVA base and KV base. So these are the important points. So in this particular single line diagram, you will have different specifications. So you will have 30 MVA, 15 MVA, 25 MVA, and 15, so etc., etc. But you need to consider, or you need to express all the values by considering a common base, common MVA base. Okay. Suppose in the problem, if he has given the common base value, MVA base, you need to choose MVA base is equal to this much and KV base is equal to this much. Obviously, very well and good. If he has not mentioned anything about the base values, so that is up to you. You need to consider or you need to take any base value. Okay. For my sincere suggestion is, if he has not mentioned anything regarding the base values, you try to consider that the value which will have less number of conversions. I will explain about this sentence, right? Suppose if you are so in this single line diagram, generator 1 is having a specifications of 30 MVA and 10.5 kV. Now, as far as the transformer 1 is concerned, you will have 11 kV instead of 10.5. So suppose if I have chosen 30 MVA and 10.5 kV as a base values for the entire session, I need to convert these values also. I need to convert this 11. So for 11 kV, it is 33. So if I consider the primary voltage is 11, the secondary voltage of the transformer 1 is 33 kV. What happens if the primary voltage has been expressed in terms of a base value 10.5? You need to find out this value. So 10.5 multiplied by 33 by 11. So you will get this one. Okay. So this will not be completed. Later, you need to change these specifications also. Why? Because basically you have chosen 10.5 kV. But based on this, you need to convert all the values. So instead of that, my suggestion is, if I consider 30 MVA and 11 kV as a base values, so the transformation or the changes, are restricted to only generator 1. Changes are restricted to generator 1. You need not convert all the values. Why? Because already it is 11 kV. So you will get 33 kV with respect to 11 kV. So 33 is already there. So 6.2 kV. So you need not convert all these values if we have chosen 11 kV. See, that is completely up to you. You need to select any value. You need to, I'm not going to say that you need to choose these values only. You need to consider these values only. I'm not going to say that. Okay. You need to choose a proper base values, which will give you less number of conversions at each and every component. Right. Now you see here. So that's why for this problem, I have chosen MVA base is equal to 30 MVA. First point, first very important thing is you need to choose proper web base values. So 30 MVA, I am considering, this is completely my assumption. 30 MVA and KV base is 11 KV. Why? Because if I choose, these are the base values which will give you less number of conversions. So 11 KV. Right? So by considering these base values, we are going to calculate the new per unit value. See, this is not acceptable. I think it is 920. Don't you have any common sense? Every time I told you that please try to join the session before 5 minutes of the commencement of class 1. Every time you are repeating the same. Okay, MVA base is equal to 30 MVA and KV base is equal to 11 KV. So first generator one, we shall start our analysis by considering generator one. So what are the actual values and that what he has given? So for generator one, old base values are for generator one. This is for generator one. First, I am going to write down the old base values, what he has given. So 30 MVA. Under 10.5. So these are the actual values what he has mentioned in the problem itself. So 10.5 kV and 1.6 ohms. Right? So in order to find out the per unit value at this particular generator one, now what shall we do now? So I am considering this as ZG1. Sorry. Okay, impedance G1 in per unit, which is equal to actual value by Z actual by Z actual by Z base. Okay. Or directly you can also consider suppose if you are getting some confusion, you just try to avoid all these things. Okay. Now simple way is for generator one, in the given problem, he has not mentioned 1.6 as per unit. He has given 1.6 ohms, nothing but that is the actual value. Okay, we are having two important expressions in our hand. Suppose what is the formula we have to use if he has mentioned per unit value at that particular component? Suppose instead of per unit, he has mentioned the actual value. What is the formula we need to use? Okay. So in this particular case, generator one is having 1.6 ohms as an actual value. So that's why to find out per unit at G1, that is mentioned as this one. So actual value by base value, actual value by base value. Now already we know that actual value is equal to 1.6 ohms. Now how do we obtain the base value for this? This is completely for generator one. So the same analysis can be extended to next transformer one, and after that you will have transmission line, and after that you will have transformer two, and after that you will have generator two section and generator three section. Okay, and in the problem itself he has given that you need to avoid the two static loads, that is static load A and static load B, right? Now Z base can be obtained as. So how do we obtain the Z base? So MVA base. So we are having a formula that. So Z base can be obtained as MVA base by KV base, right? KV base. I'm sorry. So here I have written KV base square divided by MVA base. So this is the way you are going to determine the base value of the impedance of a particular component if he has given the actual value. Now what is KV base here? So KV base is equal to, now it is 11 KV, not 10.5 KV. Why because initially we have assumed that the total base value of the entire system, I am not talking about a single component, entire system. So whatever may be the component that is connected in that particular system, that is expressed in terms of a base value of 30 MVA, okay, 11 KV. So now it is 11 KV divided by, okay, MVA base is equal to 30. Now just you determine this. So 11 square divided by 30. So what is the value you will get? What's the value you will get? So I think you will get point. Just you determine. 11 square divided by 30. So approximately you will get 121 by 30 means 4.03. So 4.03, right? So now Z G1 is equal to, that means the per unit value of the generator one section based on the new base values is given by 1.6 by 4.03. Now what you will get? 1.6 divided by 4.03. So you will get 0.397. See, once if you understand this clearly, you can easily determine the per unit value of any quantity that has been connected in the system. Okay, the first and very important point here is you need to choose proper base value. So MVA base and KV base. And after that, we are going to determine the per unit value of each and every component individually. So in that aspect, already first generator one section is there. So that's why I have taken the generator one section. So these are the actual values that he has mentioned in the problem itself. You need to determine the per unit value of this particular generator one section. So for that purpose, I am having a formula that Z G1 is equal to actual value by base value. Suppose instead of 1.6 ohms, he has given 1.6 per unit or 0.16 per unit. Obviously, you can directly take the formula that Z per unit new is equal to Z per unit old multiplied by KV base old divided by KV base new whole square multiplied by MVA base new by MVA base old. So that is a formula you are going to use. But in this particular case, he has mentioned that 1.6 ohms, that is the actual value. So that's why in order to obtain the base value, you need to consider the KV base. This is the formula, KV base whole square divided by MVA base. Already we know that the KV base is equal to 11 square divided by 30. You will get 4.03. And later, the per unit value of that particular component G1 is obtained by considering the ratio between the actual value and base value. So actual value here is 1.6 ohms and divided by the base value, what we have obtained is 4.03. So if you take the different, ratio between these two points, you will get 0.397. So you need to mention this as PU, that means per unit. Okay, don't forget about this. So this is about the generator one section. Generator one section, right? Now next term. Okay, note on this. The next one, we are going to see the next one also. That means next section is transformer one section. Transformer one section. So transformer T1. So what are the values that he has given? Next section is transformer one section. See, later we will consider all the sections combinedly, but up to that we are going to find out or determine the per unit values separately. So he has given that transformer one is of rating 15 MVA. So 11 kV primary and 15.2 ohms. See, basically we have taken 30 MVA and 11 kV as a base values. So you need not worry about much. Now in this particular case also, so Z per unit is equal to, the actual value is 15.2 divided by base value. What is the base value? MVA base by KV base whole square. Now what is KV? So 11 KV by MVA base, that is equal to 30. MVA base is equal to 30. So this is 11 square. Is it not? 11 square. See, whatever it may be, both are same, but KV base. So, sorry. If you are getting some confusion, so directly I will write down this like this. So, Z actual by. So, this is common process for all the problems. So, Z actual by Z base. Now, for this. So Z base can be obtained as KV base square by MVA base. KV base square by MVA base. Okay. Now, correspondingly, frankly speaking, either you need to consider the primary voltage or either you need to consider the secondary voltage also. Whatever it may be, both are same. But in this particular case, I am taking this as KV base is equal to 33, which is corresponding to the 11 KV by 30. Okay. Now, so you just multiply this. So Z per unit is equal to, what is the original value? That is 15.2 multiplied by 30 by 33 square. 33 square. Okay. So if you simplify this, obviously you will get 0.418 per unit. So similarly, you can determine the per unit impedances of the transmission line and the transformer two section and the remaining two, generator one and generator two. So we shall continue the same problem in the next class also. Okay. So today I'm having the invigilation. So I need to wind up the session now and I shall repeat the same in the next session also. Don't worry about that. But meanwhile, you just practice how we are going to obtain these per unit impedances of the various elements which have been connected in our system, right? Thank you.